and to think you did wrong, you do mess up. It's the process of iteration. So life becomes improvement. So you want to live for 100 years. Now, this is something someone said that I thought had a lot of meaning to it. He says, life has no meaning, but life, actually, that breath as a gift to you that gives you an opportunity to create your own meaning. Remember, we're talking about living a life of success. So we have spoken about continuous improvement, taking stock, applying medicine after death as a habit. Now we're talking about creating the life you want for yourself, the meaning that you want for yourself. You will create it. I know a lot of us will say, oh, my dad, was responsible for where I'm at, or it was my mom, or it was my brother, or it was the government. And a lot of it can be true sometimes, but we're saying that when you're being handed a lemon, you can create a lemon. Right? That's a 100 years on that page. Those boxes represent a week in your life. This is mine. I'm almost 52 weeks in a year. 100. Not creating those in a year. And at the end of every week, apply medicine after the week has died. Right? Evaluate what you did in that week. And then plan what you will do the following week. And at the end of the following week, evaluate what you did with what you planned. And then you will know if you've had a successful week. If you've had a successful week, it is great. If you have had not such a successful week, make it amber. You know that in the art this last week, make it red. When it is red a lot, then you know that you are building a life of success or not. Are you following me? But because this is yours, for your eyes only, in your diary somewhere, please recognize you have to be true to yourself. If you had a messy week and then you paint it green, you're not only not building a life that will not lead to success, you're even fooling yourself about it. So there's no remedy. And then you look back and you're done with school, maybe after 25 years, you see your peers and you hear about them in the news and nobody remembers you, and then you start to blame others. No, you cheated on that 100-year sheet. And you didn't cheat anyone but yourself. And when you color it up, so go and color the past with blue. It's past. It's the past, okay? Today is Saturday. So color from this Saturday to the first day you went on, blue. Let's start a new week. Okay? First of all, the first thing that leads you is the fact that you don't have that many boxes left. I'm only 44. I have friends. I use this to make fun of them. I have friends that are in their 50s, some early 60s. By the time I call up their boxes, they hurt to live in purpose, feel like, to achieve success. They hurt. Do not put forward anything you can do today. The common saying that says procrastination is a thief of time. If you can do it today, why can't you do it tomorrow? It's why, if I can run for governor today, why would I run when I'm 50? Because I'm 53, I'll be running for president, right? You can do it right. Not too young to run. Even if they didn't sign it, I'm old enough. Right? You can see my boxes. If you're here, and you want to commit to going down this road, not with me, but with yourself. And how do you do it? By blue marker, red marker, yellow, which represents amber, because you can't find orange marker anywhere else, and then green. So you only buy four. You create a sheet of paper, A4 paper, 52 by hunger, and then you shave blue, your days so far, or your weeks so far, and then you start this journey. If you're here and you want to do that, that is okay. Thank you for those who have raised their hands, but for those who did not, I implore you to do so. You can track projects. As a project manager, when you're doing anything, you create milestones, timelines, and all of that, and then you track. Why would you track projects and you can't track your own plan? Okay, so that's how that works. But what I'm going to talk to you about the next few minutes is how you populate the boxes. How do you make a success of each box? How do you populate it? I designed this. This is called the expression of self. Everything we are is in this model. Everything we are is right here. Self is in the center, and that's the essence of you. That's you. That thing we call me, myself, and I. A self. And the first two things you are interested in is your safety and your well-being. The protection of self is the first thing you are interested in. It's called self-preservation. Whatever you do, ensure that you have taken into account self-preservation, your well-being, and your safety. We grew up understanding that we need to protect ourselves and ensure that as much as we can, we are avoiding harm coming our way. And right after that, once you are safe again, you move into faith, family, altruism, otherwise known as charity, and friends. That is social. Fundamental to self is safety and well-being. But the moment you feel safe and that your well-being is not under threat, what you do is start to make friends. You engage your family. You go to church, mosque, or you do traditional stuff. But you engage spirituality, you have faith in something, a higher power. Or maybe faith in yourself, faith in your dad. Most people know God from their everyday, but dad is the superhero. But you have faith in something, or somehow. You engage family, you engage faith, you engage friends. And then you move right after that, and of course, that's when you begin to do good. That's when you notice that another child did come to school with shoes. That's when you notice that another child came to school and she didn't have a lunchbox. Because you have a lunchbox. You do not know life without a lunchbox. So what do? If you're so inclined, you then begin to share the content of your lunchbox. And then you move from there, and start to talk about what you want to become. That's growth. Start to talk about your moral compass. What do you stand for? Me, I can't do that. You see guys smoking and say, me, I can't do that. You see girls going up, for all night parties and say, no, I can't do that. You begin to create a moral compass. Why? Because you were already engaged faith. You were already engaged friends. You were already engaged family. And it is from those three that your moral compass is formed. What you see your family do, what you see your friends do, and what your faith teaches will form the moral compass that you design for yourself. I need to run through this. I'm already getting to this sign language. Right? And then there's your sign. And then your ambition for wealth. And then what kind of food you like, what sports you engage, education, which speaks to knowledge and enlightenment. That is, and I use knowledge and enlightenment for a reason. Knowledge you acquire to sharpen your mind. Enlightenment is for the sharpening or the nourishment of your soul. You can be knowledgeable and not enlightened, right? And then, of course, you take all of these things and you engage the outer world with it. So living a life of success is about how you do in the world out there, how you do at work, how you do, and I say at work is, for you, is school. At school, where you engage productive stuff is work, is the workplace. How do you do place of worship? How do you do at home? How do you do playground and transitional places? Ladies and gentlemen, let me announce to you, the world as we know it contains all of these six things. Everything you do in life exists in all of these six things. Work, worship, home, playground, transitional places, and the world out there. Everything you do exists in here, and you cannot engage it meaningfully if self is not whole. And what makes self whole? Pay attention to this, pay attention to this, and then you're fully formed. And here you go, ready to engage the world and engage it meaningfully. However, the greatest distraction for man is hope and nostalgia. We're at the meat of it. We're almost done. I think there's almost light out of it. That's it. Hope and nostalgia. And you will ask me, how can hope be a distraction? Hope is a distraction from present moment awareness. Nostalgia is a distraction from present moment awareness. Because these two things distract you from focusing on the present. These two things prevent you from doing something about your current state of affairs, because let's put to hope, you're looking at the future. Hope is about the future, nostalgia is about the past. Nostalgia speaks about a good, comfortable, safe place that exists in the past. Is it gone? Yes. Is that where most of us tie sometimes when we're facing challenges? Yes. Hope speaks to a better place in the future, not today, tomorrow. Tomorrow is however not guaranteed. Am I correct? But do we all hide in hope sometimes when we're facing challenges? Yes. These two places, these two emotional constructs distract us from practicing present moment awareness. However, it is through present moment awareness that you can live a fulfilling and successful life. It is through present moment awareness that you can color those boxes and color them green. Hope says look into the future, look forward. Nostalgia says look backward. And as compelling as looking forward is, the most compelling of all is looking around. Looking around says look where you are, why don't you where you've been planted. It's the same thing when you are at work or at school. Let's speak about school. Present moment awareness. Wherever you are, stay there, be there. If you're not comfortable, if you believe you shouldn't be there, then get up and leave. Don't stay there while you are thinking about other places or things. You're not maximizing the potential of that moment, and you can't do anything about where your mind is at. You're living suboptimally. I promise you, every week, you will color your box yellow or red. If you continue to be that. It's the same with how you create businesses, how you invent. When you stay in the present, you notice what's going on. When you understand the challenges, it's easier for you to come up with the solutions. You either create or only create. Those who create ask, why not? Right? To create something brand new, you must be able to ask why not. You can only ask why not when you are paying attention. It's only when you're paying attention. And so when they say your attention span, attention, it's about you. Let your mind be where your body is. Practice present moment awareness. Pay attention to your surroundings. Pay attention to what you're doing. Let your mind, spirit, and soul be where you are. It's this simple, I promise you, but this is how to live a successful life. By practicing present moment awareness. And what does that mean? Body, soul, spirit, mind, in one place, together. Or you move. And move. Or wherever you are, wherever you're planted,